Good morning, my dear students. Today we are on the part 3 of our chapter, North America. In this part of our class, we will study about case study of lumberjacks of Canada. So we have already finished physical features, political division of North America, and this is the third and last part of our chapter. So we have already finished about physical features, about the resources, so all these things we have finished. Then what is the use of studying about this case study? About the log cutters of Canada. So this word, that is lumberjacks, means the wood cutters. So what makes this wood cutters one of the most important topic in our textbook? It is because lumbering is considered as one of the most important activity of Canada and the main source of income of people of Canada. From the earlier time onwards, lumbering was considered as a work which was a cold winter job, and most of the people of Canada or the original natives were engaged in this activity. Because Canada is a very huge country with less population and more natural resources like forest. It consists of softwood trees like fir, spruce, etc., like coniferous trees, and these trees are mainly used for as making wood pulp, paper and furniture, etc. So it makes it very important because most of the people in Canada now also live by cutting these logs. It is easily available in their place and they export it to many countries. Now what are the main topics which we have to discuss in this chapter? The main topics are life of lumberjacks of Canada. In this part we will study about two things, that is ancient time or the earlier time, how those lumberjacks worked, what were their main activities, and what were their machineries and equipments which they used, and about their life, we will study. The second part we will learn about what are the new techniques which is used by them, like log rollers, pullers and chainsaws which is used now for cutting the logs, which made the work very easy. Earlier it was a very harsh job and it was a very risky job, and now it became a very common job and it is not considered as a cold winter job now. Now the next category is lumbering season. Earlier lumbering season, winter season was considered as a lumbering season because those people who go and settle in the forest, they usually go during the winter season and they stay there. They have to live in the very harsh climate. They make temporary tents and they live there, and they used to cut the logs during daytime and night because day duration is very less during that time. So they continue their work in the very cold season and they used to prepare their own food and they live in the forest. And after that, after cutting the log, they used to pile it near the river banks and they'll wait for the spring season. And when the spring season comes, they'll pull the water, or when the water melts. During the winter season, the river changes to ice, and when the river melts in the spring season, they used to pull the logs towards the water and it will be taken to the sawmill. So that was considered as a work earlier done during the winter season because it is easy for them to drag the logs during winter season with the help of sledges, etc. So this is the second topic, that is lumbering season. The third one is the phases of lumbering. What are the different phases of lumbering? There are mainly three phases of lumbering. First one is cutting the logs, then piling it up, and then the transportation. So these three divisions are there, climbing the trees and cutting, and then carrying it and keeping piling it near the river banks or in a particular area, and then the transportation. So that is what we are going to learn in the third one, that is the phases of lumbering. Now the next one is new developments in recent time. New developments means earlier axe and saws were used, more work was done by people with their hands, and now it is mechanized. So we will study about the difference between the activities done by the earlier people or the earlier lumberjacks and the lumberjacks now. Now they are using more machineries and less labor. That is what we are going to explain in this part, the new developments in recent time. The fourth one is the utility of lumber. What are the uses of lumber? Lumber is used in four ways, or the wood is used in four ways. The first one is making paper pulp, wood pulp, etc. And the second one is a particular type of cloth, like rayon is made from this wood pulp. And the next one is making paper and now we will explain and study about that in detail, the second part of our video. Export and Product Hub of Canada. So the last topic is export of this log. If this log is transported or sold in Britain, USA or many other countries where this log is less. So they used to export this, they export it as timber and they also export it as wood pulp for man paper etc. And Canada is considered as the largest exporter of wood pulp in the world. So all these details will be taught in the second part of this video with the help of PowerPoint. So what are the main topics here? You can see life of lumberjacks, lumbering season, phases of lumbering, new developments and the utility of lumber and export and product. So these are the main topics. Now we'll wind up our class here with the third part, and now after this you can watch our PowerPoint presentation, and in that every point will be given in detail and you can study that, and many questions are there that you can write and learn. So let's start our PowerPoint presentation.
Lumberjacks of Canada. Lumbering is one of the most important industry of Canada. The lumberjacks, they were not having any good camps, equipments, etc. in the ancient or in the earlier times. The nature endowed North America with vast and rich resources, and this lumbering is one of the main activity of Canadians. It consists of forest activities like felling of trees, logging, splitting, halting timber, etc. These people, the lumberjacks, they live in a harsh climate without any amenities. You can see the picture of lumberjacks. This was the way in which they were working in the earlier time. Now their condition changed. Now they are using so many new techniques for cutting the trees. Lumbering season. Lumbering is considered as a cold winter job, and the lumberjacks had to live in the taiga forest. Taiga forest is a very cold region. Taiga forest is found in the cold region, in a permafrost area, and along with that it consists of softwood trees and coniferous trees. They cut the logs and then they drag it to the riverside with the help of sledges. They pile up the logs on the frozen river bank, awaiting the spring season. When the river melted, the logs were pushed into the Solon River and then taken into the mills. So this is the main activity of a lumberjack. They cut the trees, then they drag it and pile it up near the frozen river bank, because this activity is done during the winter season. And when the winter season completes and when the spring season comes, the water, the river starts melting. At that time, they push the logs towards the water and the logs will go towards the city area or the river where the river flows. Through that portion it will flow, and there are many people are there who works as a log, who considered as a log jammer, who remove the log jams etc., and they'll lead the logs towards the mills. You can see a permafrost region here, the first picture. That area is fully covered with ice, and in this condition the logs are cut, and after that the logs are dragged with the help of sledges in the earlier time. Now it is not considered as a cold winter job because so many new machineries, vehicles etc. are available. So it is not considered as a cold winter job now. You can see the logs here. Now we'll move to the next part, that is what are the three phases of lumbering. The first three phases of lumbering is, first one is high riggers. High riggers are the people who climb the trees and cut the branches. Sawers or buckers are the people who cut the trunk with saw and axes. Skidders are people who collect the logs, stack them along the frozen river bank. And the fourth one is the transporter. And the transporter means who carry the logs to the sawmill, maybe through the river or by any other vehicle. So the first three are important. It is the first one is cutting the trees, second one is piling it up and storing it, and the third one is transporting it to the sawmill. We can see machineries which is used now for cutting the trees. New developments have taken place in lumbering method in recent time. Many new developments have taken place in lumbering method. They are using of extensive mechanization and scientific methods have greatly reduced the manual labor. Earlier manual labor was more, machines were less or instruments were less. Now it is fully mechanized. Power driven chainsaws, log loaders, lifting trailers, tanks, tractors, etc. are used. Dams are built to drive the logs towards the sawmill. So these are the main techniques which is used now. They are most of the activities done by the machines. Then power driven saw chains, log lifters, all these works are mechanized, and then dams are made so that they can lead the water towards the sawmill. The utility of lumber. Logs are used to manufacture wood pulp, newsprint, paper, etc. Timber is used in the construction and furniture industry. British Columbia has many timber-based industries and plywood production. Pulp is also used in the production of synthetic fiber, and the name of that fiber is rayon. So, utility of lumber, what is the use of this wood? It is used as a wood pulp for newsprint and picking paper. Then it is used in the construction industry, and it is used in the plywood making industry, and also making a synthetic fiber called rayon. So these four things are very important. The first one is it is used for manufacturing wood pulp, newsprint and paper, then furniture, then plywood, and the last one is a synthetic fiber rayon. The product hub of Canada. The main production hubs are Quebec, Montreal and Toronto. Wood is used for making paper, newsprint, timber, furniture, etc. in Canada. It is the fourth largest producer and the largest exporter of paper in the world. About the export, Canada has a large supply of timber and timber products for export. Canada exports its surplus to USA, Britain, as well as many other countries where timber is in short supply. The lumbering industry is an important foreign exchange for Canada. So this is all about the case study of lumberjacks of Canada. We have discussed about the life of lumberjacks, lumbering season, the phases of lumbering, new developments, utility of lumber and export, and product hub of Canada. So these are the main points of this portion of our chapter. It is the last part, it is the third part of our chapter. And the map study is already given. You can see that, and you can make the map and you can study that. And in the previous video, I have attached the countries and capitals which you have to by heart. Learn that also, write that also in your copy. So study well for the exam. This is the last topic of our second semester. And now after this, two question papers will be uploaded in the YouTube channel. You can watch that. You can write. You can try to write that questions, and prepare well for the exams. If doubts are there, you can ask me at any time. Thank you.